Well, now to jobs. A new report out tonight shows there are a record 214,000 job openings right now.
There are more job openings than people looking for work. Heidi Wigdahl has more on the impact that has on our local economy.
Job openings have reached a record high in the state, over 214,000 openings in the last quarter of 2021.
We still are looking. We are looking for more.
Restaurant owner Leah Raimundo says her biggest challenge is filling hours for her new Filipino restaurant, Calzada.
They're going to work for 1 week, and then they're going to ask for 2 weeks vacation, and then come back to work and for 1 week and then vacation again.
At the occupation level, demand in the state was highest for food prep and serving workers with almost 33,000 vacancies.
While we're looking at these vacancies as a big challenge for our economy, they are also a sign of an economy that is coming back and where growth is happening.
Steve Grove, commissioner of the Minnesota Department of Employment and Economic Development, says job vacancies were up 68% compared to the same time frame in 2020. While vacancies are on the rise, unemployment is down. There are fewer than 93,000 unemployed workers. That means 0.4 unemployed persons for each vacancy, a record low. And while Grove is optimistic about the state's economy,
is it concerning? Yes, it is concerning. We need more workers in our state, and we need to think about this really holistically.
DEET has launched its Summer of Jobs campaign to connect employers to those looking for work. The campaign includes job shadowing some of the best paying in-demand jobs available in the state. Grove says businesses need to embrace automation. DEET is also focused on recruiting.
We can't be complacent right now as it relates to promoting our state. It is just too competitive out there.
DEET's campaign this summer will also point employers to people who are often overlooked for jobs, including those in immigrant communities, workers with disabilities, and people recently released from correctional facilities. And this is a statewide campaign. It'll kick off next week, first focusing on manufacturing jobs.
All right, let's hope it's successful.
Yep.
Thanks, Heidi.